If you only like philosophy, then be a philosopher. If you only like history, then be a historian. If you only like mathematics, be a mathematician. But if you like all those things, you should be an economist. An economist, I think, is motivated by questions, audibly policy questions. How should a government respond to this economy? What should regulatory behavior be? How should I think about health care reform? How do I think about development in poor countries? They seem like some of the biggest questions. Economics provides a coherent, I think, elegant way to think about answers to those questions. I always tell my students that, in some sense, economists just observe what history has served up. The problem is many of the interesting experiments in the world haven't been played out in history. So instead, what we do is we write down a model, where the model is a series of equations that somehow describe behavior of the people in this sort of pretend economy. A big chunk of my work is writing down models where you have non-trivial lending problems. It's often the case that in models, for simplicity, we assume that borrowers and lenders can sort of agree to terms of a loan and can interact pretty easily. But there's a difficulty because the saver does not know for sure what the borrower is going to do with these resources, right? So there's this question of, do I trust you? I write down models where borrowers are able to attract resources from savers only if they provide some value to the project to begin with. Now, models like that are particularly interesting in the last couple of years because we saw major declines in the ability of firms and banks to raise external funds because of a decline in their asset positions. So suddenly you have an institution that has less value associated with it, and so you can see how savers sort of collectively are less willing to provide funds to that institution. One should not do modeling without a question in mind. Students often come in interested in economics broadly, unemployment rates, inflation. So they're interested in policy questions, but they often have no coherent logical structure to think about them. The first couple years of graduate school are to teach you the rigorous structure to be able to answer questions. You learn all this mathematics, but at the end of this process, it's often the case that they've lost sight of the policy questions. As a faculty advisor, the thing to do is focus on what is the question you're interested in. Why does that question matter? What would you do with the answer to that question? You should always begin there. There's so many important questions we don't know answers to. There's so many important questions that policymakers would like some input on. Once you start to think about economics, it's hard to think about anything else.